हेलो हेलो,
यस सर।
या सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी सा हाउ टू राइट फंक्शंस इन पाइथन। सो व्हाट इज द कीवर्ड टू डिफाइन फंक्शंस इन पाइथन? डेफ इज द कीवर्ड दैट वी यूज टू डिफाइन फंक्शन। ओके, डेफ फॉलोड बाय नेम ऑफ द फंक्शन, देन कोलन, देन वी डिफाइन द बॉडी ऑफ द फंक्शन। सो हाउ टू इनवोक ए फंक्शन, हाउ टू मेक ए फंक्शन कॉल, जस्ट लाइक हाउ वी डू फंक्शन कॉल इन सी
पासिंग एड्रेस
प्रोग्रामिंग।
और वैल्यूज।
या सो हाउ वी डू फंक्शन कॉल इन सी प्रोग्राम, इन द सेम वे हियर ऑल्सो वी कॉल द फंक्शन, सेम सिंटैक्स। बट हियर देर इज नो कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ पास बाई वैल्यू, हियर एवरीथिंग इज पास बाई रेफरेंस। दैट मीन्स वॉट एवर द चेंजेस दैट हैपन्स विथ इन द फंक्शन, सो दैट विल बी डायरेक्टली अफेक्टेड टू द memory address of the variables. Okay, so therefore whatever the changes that you do in the sub function will also be affected to the main function, because directly you are doing the changes to the memory address of the variables. So now for that we'll see one example. So before that, so 1 minute. Students, now I'll share the screen. You see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now look at here. So one more example, okay, to demonstrate how this pass by reference will work in Python. So look at here. So first I have a function, so by name hello function, and there is one name, so sorry, one parameter by name names. So look at here, what is the parameter, from where I am passing the parameter? So here I am creating a list. This is nothing but an array list. So names is equal to Susan, Peter, and William. So I have a list with three elements. Then I am calling the function hello function, and I'm passing this array list as a parameter. So what I'm passing? Array list as a parameter. Okay. So just if we specify the name of the array as a parameter, that is good enough. Now here in the function, see here how I am printing the names. For n, n is a iteration variable in names, print hello, followed by name of the item stored in the array list. So hello, so what is the first item? Susan. So it in the first iteration it will print hello Susan. In the second iteration, n represents Peter, and in the third iteration, n represents William. So it will print hello Susan, hello Peter, and hello William. So after that, see, we are coming out of the for loop. So now I am reinitializing the variables. That is, in the first index I am inserting Suresh, and in the second index value I am inserting Preeti, and in the third index value I am inserting Rajesh. That means later on I am replacing actually the values. Now we will see how then after that come out of the function, then print within the main function, you print the names are now. Okay, what this will print? This will print Suresh, Preeti, and Raj. Why? Because we are making changes to the array list by using its array address. So in the zeroth address we are inserting Suresh, in the first index we are inserting Preeti, and in the second index we are inserting Raj. Let us see the output. See, now here in the bottom you can see the output here. First it is printing hello Susan, hello Peter, and hello William. After that you can see here, see, first here it is, in this line it is printing hello Susan, hello Peter, and hello William. After that you can see it is printing the names are now Suresh, Preeti, and Raj. See, we are reinitializing within the function, we are reinitializing the values. After that, once the function executes, control will come back to this main function. Then from after that, the next line is the names are, okay, you can see here. The names are Suresh, Preeti and Raj. So this is how the concept of pass by reference will work in Python. Now let us consider one more example. See here, this is the example to demonstrate nested functions. Students, you know, right? What are nested functions? If you are calling one function within the body of another function, we call it as nested function. Okay, once again I repeat, if you are calling a function within the body of another function, we call it as nested function. So if you look at the source code of this program, so this is one function, print message is one function, and repeat message is one function. Then in the main program, that is within the, as part of the main function, we have only one line as the code. So we have only one line, that is repeat message. So here what I'll do, I'll call repeat message. So control will be, so it will check where the function with name repeat message is defined. So it will come here. So it is defined here. So what is the first line? Print message. So within that function, we are calling one more function by name print message. So it will come here. So it will check where it is defined, print message. So it is defined here. It will come here and it will print, hi, how are you? Then insert new line, then display, have a nice day. Then once again, insert new line. Then once again, come back here. Then after that, once again, we are calling the same function repetitively for the next time. So once again, it will come here. Once again, it will print, hi, how are you? Insert new line, then have a nice day. Once again, insert new line, come back. So it has finished execution of repeat message. Then once again, control will be back to repeat message. So after that, we don't have any other statements to execute. So terminate the program. Hello, students. Are you listening? Hello? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So you got the concept. What are nested functions? A function which is defined inside the body of another function is called as nested function, like this. See, so this is the example of nested function. Under the repeat message, we are calling print message. Now we'll run this program. So look at here. So now we have called repeat function. So inside that, see here, inside repeat function, we are calling print message. So it display these two lines. Okay, since we are calling it twice, two times it is repeating the same message because we are calling it two times. Okay, students, any doubt in this? Shall I move on to the next program? Hello, next example.
Yes, sir.
So next example is all about how to read keyboard input. See, so far we didn't read keyboard input or what? Yes, in our lab set program, we read input from the keyboard, isn't it? So tell me, what is the function that we use to read keyboard from the, to read input from the keyboard? What is the function that we used? So that is the input function. So can you see this program? Print off. See, there are two ways in which you can read input from the keyboard. See, in the first example, in the first line, what I am doing? Print, what is your name? Okay, in the second example, I'm using S is equal to input, enter your hometown. Okay, so then in the first example, what is happening actually, the input is a function, Actually, its return type is string. If you are using print statement, it will return to the standard output device. That means it will return to the on the screen. It will return to the screen. What you are entering, that will be returned to the screen. Otherwise, if you do not use the print statement along with import, then you have to use left side variable to store what you are reading from the keyboard. So whatever you read from the keyboard, that should be stored into the left side variable. Okay, now look at this. So what is your name? So for example, okay, I'll enter some name. Okay, I'll place the cursor there. Yes. What happened? Okay, you can see I'm entering Suresh. Then enter hometown. Okay, I'll enter Bangalore. Okay. So now you can see here. So this is one technique of you reading from the keyboard. So if you want to read from the keyboard, and if you don't want to store the value in any of the variable, then you can use print statement. But this technique is not suggested. Okay, this is not a suggested option. This is not a suggested option. Okay, we always okay. This is the right way to read from a keyboard. Okay, this is the right way to read from the keyboard. Always you have to use one left side variable, then use input function, then enter the message. So that whatever you enter from the keyboard, it will be stored in the left side variable. Then later, if you want to print it on the terminal, use print statement and you print it on the terminal. Okay, control S, then F5, run. Now, what is your name? So I'll enter something. Okay, enter your hometown. Okay, same thing is by using the print statement we are displaying. Now you can see here. See, first I while entering, when it asked what is your name, I entered Raj. That is also printed on the terminal. Why? Because here we are using print statement. We know that always print will return to the screen. It will return to the screen. It will write output to the screen. Same thing. So it is doing here. But in this case, when I used S is equal to input, say for example, now if I make it as a comment, now it will not print the hometown name. This I will enter, but it will not return anything. Enter your name. Raj. Okay. So enter your hometown. I'll enter Bangalore, but it will not return. So it will not return. So explicitly we have to use the print statement to print it on the terminal. So control S, F5. Okay. Now it will return back to the terminal. So like that, we need to deal with the keyboard input. See, earlier in the earlier version, that is in Python 2.2.x, we are using a method called raw input. Okay, so now let us see what happens if we use raw method, raw input here in 3.8.5. So let us assume x is equal to raw input of enter your pin code. So I want to read the pin code from the keyboard. okay, then print of x. And here I want to give one new line. Okay, fine, control S, F5. So what is your name? Okay, is that your hometown? Bangalore. Okay, see here, it is throwing the error. Name raw input is not defined. So line number 5 in module, x is equal to raw input, enter your pin code, name error, name raw input is not defined. That means now this raw input is a method which is deprecated or which is not allowed, which is not deprecated, it is not allowed in Python 3.x. So in case if you are using Python 2.x, then only you can use this raw input to read from the keyboard. So otherwise, if you are using Python 3.x, better not to use this method. So just I'll make a comment. This is a method of Python 2.x. Friends, whenever you refer some material in the internet or in the textbook, sometimes you may see this method. X is called raw input is a method which is used to read from the input. That means you need to understand that. So they are using Python 2.x. Similarly for the print statement, also they may use directly like this: print space x to print the value of x. If this is a syntax, then also you need to understand that is Python 2.x. So whereas in Python 3.x, we use bracket along with the print statement. Okay, those are the small things that you need to understand. So those are the syntactic differences between Python 2.x and Python 3.x. Okay, students, now okay, I'll explain. See, this yesterday it was holiday. Actually yesterday we were supposed to execute lab set program. So let us see what is the third lab set program. What is our third lab set program? So our third lab set program is write a program to search an element using linear search. That means we have to implement the linear search algorithm. So how to implement this linear search algorithm? Let us see. So first I'm creating a list. This is an empty list. So li is equal to square bracket. That means not at all initializing anything, just creating an empty list. Then I'm reading from the keyboard. That is enter the length of the array, that is enter the n value. Then I am typecasting that value because the moment I read from the keyboard, it will be assumed that, so always you know that input returns string value. So I am converting that string into integer, so that will be stored in the n. Then taking two temporary variables, flag and count, and initializing them to zero. So later I want to use it this flag in if condition, okay, to decide whether the element is found or not. Now read the elements. For i in range of n, this is nothing but writing for int I is equal to 0, I is less than n, I plus plus. So this statement is equivalent to for I is equal to 0, I is less than n, and I plus plus. X is equal to input of enter element, then store at store. See, str is the function. Okay, so see, you can see here. So enter, it will show enter element 1, enter element 2. Okay, that is what enter element. Okay, this is 1. This will display enter element 1. So initially I value is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1 in the first iteration. Then to add it to the list, li dot append. So append is the method that we use to add items into the list. Okay, say for example, n value is 5. Okay, so whatever you enter the first element, that will be stored in x. Okay, it will display enter element str. Str is the string function. I plus 1, that is enter the element 1 colon. So you will enter, that will be stored in x. Then add that x to the list by using name of the list dot append. Then increment the I value, that is in the second iteration I value is 1. Okay, input of enter element string of I plus 1, that is 1 plus 1 is 2, that is enter element 2, store it in x. Once again add that element to the list using append. Then I value gets incremented. Now I value becomes 2. So enter the element I plus 1, that is 3. Enter the element 3. Once again add, I value incremented, element 4. So I value is 4. So enter the element. So I plus 1. So I plus 1 is here 4. Enter element 4. Okay, once again append. Then similarly last element. Okay, so enter, now I value is 4. So enter the element I plus 1 is 5. So add the element. Now increment the I value, it becomes 5. So 5 is less than 5, no, condition becomes false, because now we have reached the 5 elements range. So now come out of the for loop. Then print the array elements are, it will print all the elements of the array. You can see here how it will print the elements. The elements are, it will print all the elements in one shot. To do this, just to display the elements of the array in C program or in C++, we need to have a for loop. But here in Python, you need not use any for loop to display all the elements of the array in one shot. Okay, just if you specify the name of the list within the print statement, it will display all the elements. Then now enter what is the element that you want to search. Okay, enter the element and do the typecasting, convert that element into integer, then store it in item variable. Now we do the actual search. Now this is the actual, now this is the core logic. Okay, now what I am, you can see this shaded portion, this is the core logic of linear search. For I in list, for I in list, count is equal to count plus 1. So initially count is equal to 0, isn't it? Initially count is equal to 0. If item is equal to I, then flag is equal to 1. That means if the you search all the elements one by one from the list, so that if the item, whatever the search item that you have entered here, if that is matching with the item within the list, then set the flag is equal to 1 and come out of the loop. Okay, otherwise if you keep checking all the elements one by one. Okay, so otherwise what happens, initially we have initialized flag is equal to 0, that remains flag is equal to 0 itself. So whenever the element is matching with the, whenever the search element is matching with the item in the list, we will set flag is equal to 1 and we will come out of the loop. So if flag is equal to 1, search is successful, found at count position. See here, in the first iteration, count is equal to count plus 1, that is 0 plus 1. If the element that is found is first element, its position is 1. If the element is found in the second iteration, so in the first iteration count will be 1, so it is count plus 1, that is count plus 1 is 2. So like that, to print the position we use this count variable. If flag is equal to 1, search is successful, otherwise flag search is unsuccessful. Students, to this program actually what we are demonstrating is, we are demonstrating how to use the list, how to create an empty list, then how to initialize variables from the keyboard, how to initialize the array from the keyboard. That is one concept. Then how to use the break statement. For example, if you may get a question like, demonstrate the use of break statement in Python with suitable example. Demonstrate the use of break keyword with suitable example, then you can write this program. Or if you get the program question like, demonstrate the concept of list with a suitable example, then also you can write this program. So whenever we study any program, just we need to understand what are all the concepts that we can demonstrate through this program. Okay, see, the main problem statement is linear search. So we are searching. Linear means what? Search element by element from I is equal to 0 till I less than n. You search one element after the another element, whether the element is found in the list or not. If it is found, the search is successful, otherwise the search is not successful. You can see the output here. So enter the elements of the array. So n value is 5. So then enter element 1, 2, enter element 1, element 2, 3, 4 and 5. See, for that, here we have written the logic. Within the for loop, enter the element str of I plus 1, that is 0 plus 1 is enter element 1. In the second iteration, enter element 2. So this is displaying. Students, any doubt in this?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, this is linear search. Similarly, we can also do the binary search. See, in the previous semesters itself, you have done linear search and binary search, isn't it, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now today I'll give you one task, that is, you need to execute this LabSet program 3, then in the last line of the output you have to display your USN number. Okay, search is successful. After that, 1BY, okay, so 19MC01, 1BY 19MC02, like that you display your, you have to display the output of the program along with source code and the program along with USN number. So that is, instead of quiz, you have to do that task today. So how much time you need to execute this program? Still we have 25 minutes remaining. I think 25 minutes are good enough for you to type this program. If you want to copy the program, just you can take the screenshot. Students, take the screenshot. Did you take the screenshot?
Sir, instead of list of arrangements, we should give a USN number. No,
see, you implement the same logic. At the end, you display one print statement which contains your USN. So for me, that is the indication that this student has executed.
Okay, sir.
Getting
that. Okay, sir.
Yeah. So just at the end, you add one print statement which will display your USN. Anything, students, you want to ask? Even if you implement it in another way, also not an issue. So just we want the outcome of linear search. Then that should also display your USN.
Sir, you want us to do right now, sir?
Yeah, right now you do.
Sir, this is right activity. Now I don't have power. I'm using my mobile, sir.
Okay, then that is fine. So later, but by today you have to post the answer.
We should send in the email, sir.
Yeah, email.
Okay, sir.
Okay, you should send it in the email. Now, before that, shall I close this? Students, shall I close this?
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Okay.
I'll close this. Stop sharing. Now I'll call the attendance. Answer for your attendance. Now I'll start with 1BY series. 1BY series. USN 1.
Present, sir.
2.
Present, sir.
3.
Present, sir.
4. 5.
Present, sir.
6.
Yes, sir.
7.
Present, sir.
8.
Present, sir.
9.
Present, sir.
10. 10. Yes, and 10. 11.
Present, sir.
12.
Present, sir.
13.
Present, sir.
14.
Present, sir.
15. 16.
Present, sir.
17.
Present, sir.
18.
Present, sir.
19.
Present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21.
Present, sir.
22.
Present, sir.
23.
Present, sir.
24.
Present, sir.
25.
Present, sir.
26.
Present, sir.
27.
Yes, sir.
28.
Yes, sir.
29.
Yes, sir.
30.
Present, sir.
So now I'll start with the TD series. One TD series. One. One is absent. Two.
Present, sir.
Three.
Present, sir.
Four.
Present, sir.
Five.
Present, sir.
Six.
Six, present, sir.
Seven.
Present, sir.
Eight.
Yes, sir.
Nine.
Present, sir.
Ten.
Present, sir.
11.
Yes, sir.
12.
Present, sir.
13.
Present, sir.
14.
Yes, sir.
15.
Present, sir.
16. 16. 17.
Yes, sir.
18.
Present, sir.
19. 19.
Present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21.
Present, sir.
22.
Present, sir.
23.
Present, sir.
Okay. Okay, students. So today, so you do
sir,
this
Ambrish.
Program. Yeah. Hello.
Ambrish, present.
Ambrish, 1BY series. What is your USN?
04, sir.
4, okay.
04.
Okay, okay. Fine. Students, tomorrow we'll continue with under functions only one concept is remaining, that is repeated functions. So that is recursion. Only recursion is pending. Okay, tomorrow we'll start with recursive functions, and we'll study some more new concepts. Okay, so for tomorrow we'll be studying recursion, how to implement recursion in Python, then followed by some new concepts. Thank you. Now you execute the program and post the results. Thank you.